Pals, this week we're going to be learning about pasta. And we're going to learn about the different types of pasta, the different kind of shapes. We're going to learn about where it comes from, what it is made out of. And then I can answer any questions that you guys have, either in a Zoom meeting with Robin or maybe in an email from one of your parents. But I'm going to cover a lot of history so that hopefully I can answer most of your questions. Firstly, when most people think about pasta, so if you're trying to picture that in your head, you'll think about spaghetti or maybe macaroni, and you'll usually think about those as being like Italian foods. But the thing that I learned, it is actually very likely, so they really think this is the answer to this, that pasta comes from ancient Asia, which when we learned about the continents, Asia is pretty far away from us. Some people think that in Asia there was a recipe for making pasta, and that someone brought that recipe from Asia to Italy, and they think it was someone who probably visited China. So the reason they think that is because some archaeologists and historians, so people who study this, believe that in Central Asia, which is the middle of Asia, they think that is probably the first place where Asian noodles were made. And so that would be where the original recipe came from, the one that traveled with somebody to Italy. The exact way that the recipe was brought to Italy and who specifically brought it to Italy is still unclear. So people are not 100% sure about that part of pasta history. Almost every single country in the world has its own version of pasta. So they have a different style that they make it, or maybe they have a similar style to another country's, but every single country almost has their own kind of pasta. So there are many, many different varieties or types. There's different shapes, different ingredients, things like that. So for example, some of those would be in Germany or in Hungary, they have something called spätzle. And in Greece, they have orzo. In Poland, they make things called pierogies. And in America, we actually make and we serve pasta that's very similar to how it is made in Italy. So ours is pretty similar, and that's because a lot of Italian people came to America and they were creating the pasta that was authentic to their country. So Italian pasta when they came to America. They think, so this is an estimated number, that means it's an about number, so not an exact number, but pretty close, that Italian people eat over 60 pounds of pasta every year for each person, which is really, really, that's a crazy big amount. To compare it to Americans, so how much people in our country eat pasta, they say that each American person eats about 20 pounds of pasta a year, which is still a lot, so it's a very, very popular food here. In America, we mostly use, if you are cooking pasta at home, or maybe if you went to a restaurant and got some pasta, it is mostly imported from Italy. So that means that it was shipped here from their country. Someone had to deliver it, it had to come over on a boat, or travel here in some other way. And the dried pasta that I'm talking about is the sort of pasta, if you go to the grocery store, or you look in your cabinet at home, that would come either in a box or maybe it would come sealed in a bag, and it's really hard. Maybe you've done some art activities too where you could make like a pasta necklace or something like that. You'll notice that the pasta is very hard. And that's because when the pasta is dried, you have to boil it in a pot of water to get it soft enough to eat. So maybe you've seen someone preparing pasta that way. That's because in America, it's very common for us to eat dried pasta and not the fresh sort of pasta. video, we're going to learn more about different types of pasta. But something I can tell you now is that all pasta throughout the world, it might have some extra ingredients, but the three basic ingredients in all of pasta are eggs, water, and flour. Those are the three main ingredients, and that was in the original recipe that went from China to Italy, where they made it very, very popular. People use these ingredients and they make some sort of a dough, and then they can roll out that dough and they can cut the pasta into different shapes, whether they want to make it into like a spaghetti, or if they want to make it into a sort of shell shape. And there are different machines to help people do that, and sometimes people will cut the pasta by hand with a knife. We're going to learn more about that and the shapes and the different sizes of pasta in our next video.